If you have submitted your information to get a biometrics appointment at a VFS center in your country and you haven't heard back from them, or if you have received an email from them that there is going to be a delay in that appointment, then this is the video that you must be watching, because I have a couple of clients who are in India right now who had received a delay email and some did not even receive that email, but they have finally gotten their scheduling of submitting their biometrics information to the VFS in India. Please be tuned till the end. My name is Sahil and I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant. So guys, welcome back once again. My name is Sahil and I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant and I practice here inside Ontario, Canada. My office is here, and if you want to get in touch with us for any of your requirements, please feel free to book an appointment with us and speak to us. My details are there on the screen right now and in the description box. You can schedule an appointment and we would be more than happy to help you out. Guys, before we proceed further, if you are watching this video for the first time, I request you to kindly subscribe to the channel and hit the like button, the bell icon, because every time we release a new video on Canadian immigration, we talk a lot about Canadian immigration, any program or delivery related updates. And if you hit the bell icon, you will be notified about any new video and an update that we post on YouTube or any other channel. Guys, let's just quickly get on with this topic of today, which is about biometrics, submitting that particular information to the VFS in your particular country. So guys, a couple of days ago, VFS in India especially had actually tweeted that if you want to submit, if you're a part of the family sponsorship or a student, you are in the priority sequence right now. And if you want to submit your information to them, you must submit a form to book your appointment with them in order to submit your biometrics information. So guys, there are a couple of steps involved after you do that. So I have a couple of students in India right now who are on their way, the files are under processing, who are on their way of submitting all of this information while the files are being processed. So there are two separate categories. I'll tell you and I'll be sharing their experience with you so that you can be fitting in one of those situations. So what had happened was all of them had actually submitted the form for submitting their biometrics information. They had received the biometrics instruction letter and I had actually passed on to them. So they went ahead and scheduled their appointment. So one of them received an appointment confirmation the same day that she had actually submitted. So probably a day later, she received an email that the appointment has been confirmed. But the other few guys had actually received an email that said that your appointment is going to be delayed. So I have these emails printed out so that I'm not going to share their names or anything, not even the program numbers, but I'm just going to tell you what they had actually received so that you can be sort of informed. At least I can at least share their experience with you. So guys, the first experience that I can share with you is that they had received a particular email from info on Canada Visa 2 in India. That is a particular email that they sent. They said that we are aware that you are waiting for your appointment slot in enrolling a biometrics. Following the resumption of biometric enrollment services, the family class priority and the student permits for Canada, please note we are witnessing high volumes of appointments and the team is actually doing their best to help the applicants. So they also said that due to high demand, they're experiencing certain particular delays and they will get back to the applicant in a couple of days. Okay, which they did in a couple of days, and they had actually sent them one email which had one attachment which talked about the appointment confirmation, the date and the time. Okay, so there was one email that particular said that hey, this is with regards to your confirmation of the appointment that you had sent, and the subject was appointment confirmation. It clearly talked about the reference number of the application, the date, the time and the location of submitting the information to VFS. The email clearly said that kindly refer to the appointment letter which is attached to that email. Okay, and this is that particular attachment that I'm referring to. So apart from the personal details, I'm just going to read out the content. So it has the applicant name, reference number, the appointment date and the appointment time. Okay, And then below that is the all the directions that you should be reaching at least 30 minutes before that, and you should not carry these items, you should carry such and such items. It's just basically a one pager that talks about the confirmation of the appointment and gives you the address where you need to reach. Okay, so I have the couple of clients I have from Pune, from Delhi, from Chandigarh. So guys, everything is on track, no need to worry. My clients are getting their biometrics appointments confirmed and they are moving ahead with submission of their biometric information. So they are scheduled for this week, that is ongoing. So within this week, all of them will be submitting their information to the VFS in India. Guys, I hope the video actually shares a couple of steps. So I'll just brief you quickly again. One, you go ahead, book your appointment. Then you will receive a confirmation of appointment from the VFS. It will give you directions when to and where to present yourself to submit the biometrics information. And you must wait for the information or the appointment confirmation to come your way. So guys, I hope this is helpful. And if you still have any doubt, please feel free to reach out to us on the number on the screen or book an appointment. And we will try our best to help you out. Once again, all the best and see you soon in Canada.